Now we are going to see about a topic that is of transgenic animals. In this transgenic animals, we are having of three peculiar terms. One is of transgene, another one is transgenics, another one is transgenesis. So we are having of three words. First, we should know the meaning for these three words. First one is of transgenic or transgene. Transgene is our desired DNA. For an example, here I have mentioned it is a word as alien DNA. So this alien DNA will be injected into the animals so that it will replicate as well as it will transcribe and translate it into a protein. It will produce the protein in an enormous amount, thus will be retrieved by the human being. That is of transgene. Transgenic, we call it as the particular host where the alien DNA has been inserted, we call it as transgenic animals. Transgenesis is a process how we are inserting that alien DNA into an animal. So here we are having of three things. One is of transgene, nothing but our alien DNA. Transgenic, that is of your animal to whom we are inject our alien DNA, and the process that we are following we call it as transgenesis. For what reason we are making of this transgenic animal is, the first one is we have to check out how the genes are regulated inside the genome. So we have already studied about a group of gene, we call it as a genome. So each and every gene has been arranged in a genome. It is having of its own specific function. So through this we are going to find out, we are going to regulate their expression. The meaning of regulation is controlling. Whenever there is a needed of a protein, it can be triggered. Otherwise, enormous amount is presented over, it should be of control. That regulation has to be done with the help of your transgenic animals. It will be checked over there. Then second one is how the gene affects the normal function of a body. Okay, this is of like diagnostics. The third one is of how it affects the growth and development of a particular organism. For an example, if you are injecting a cancerous cells into a mice, into a normal mice, what happened? This cancerous cells will divide it into a numerous one so that it will affect the growth and development of a particular mice. So through that we can make of an analysis. For that, using as a laboratory animals, this transgenic has been used for. Apart from that, human important proteins, that is therapeutic proteins, will be produced inside the transgenic animals for their welfare. The transgenic animals is known for their biological effects as well as the results in the human welfare. So here I have the diagram depict about how the transgenic animals has been taken off. So this is of your animals, that is of laboratory animals. This is one is of your transgene. So this transgenes has been inserted into the cell, that is egg cell is there, with the help of a suction pipette, that is of micro injection method, it has been injected into the transgene has been injected into the particular organisms during of embryonic development. Otherwise directly it will be injected into the mice. Direct method may also be used over. Laterally it will induces the formation of the new species. This new species is having of this transgenic expression. When comparing of this original, that is of parental, along with of a new one, several differences will be presented over. That is, here it is having of normal expression. For example, it is having of 20 genes, means here it is having of 21 genes. Additional gene is nothing but of a transgene. So the expression of this gene is also different. Through that, several studies will be carried over. That is, how the genes are regulated, how the genes affects the normal function of a body, how it affects the growth and development of a body. Several case studies will be carried over with the help of this production. Apart from the case studies, it is also having a beneficial effects for the human beings. That has been given in this slide, that is of biological products and their uses. The first one is study of diseases. The transgenic animals are designed to understand how genes contribute to the development of a diseases. So when we are injecting a disease-oriented pathogens or a part of a pathogens inside a living cells, that is of animals, what happened? It will replicate inside the body so that it will make some confusions inside of the genes. Along with the normal action, it will also produce this abnormal reaction. These kind of activities will make as a case study. That is the first point, study about the disease that occurs inside of a animals. The second one is biological products. The human important products, that is of therapeutical protein. Apart from therapeutical protein, some important carbohydrates or fats or any other thing may also be produced inside the animal host. Later it will be extracted through their milk or any other part. For an example, I am giving of alpha 1 antitrypsin. It was injected into the cattle. So with the help of a vector, it was injected into the cattle. The enormous production of antitrypsin was used for to treat of emphysema. This antitrypsin production was carried out in the mammary cells. So in the milk of the particular cattle, the transgenic animal, a transgenic cow, is having an enormous amount of production of alpha 1 antitrypsin. Due to the extractions of the milk will contain this antitrypsin. So we can use that milk as a medicine to treat of your emphysema. Likewise, it is also used to treat of phenylketonuria. It is also a disorder. Then cystic fibrosis, this is also a disorder. Likewise, many biological products may be used to cure of diseases. It will act as a therapeutic product to cure the diseases that occurred in the human beings. Then vaccine safety. So whenever a person is infected by a diseases, what happens? They may be treat of medicines. The vaccine safety is must, but first, after the production of a vaccine, it should not be directly injected into the human beings. It has to be make a lab trial. That lab trial will be carried out in case of transgenic animals. Mostly it has been occurred in mice, rabbits, ducks, etc. Why? Because to find out the side effects of the particular vaccines. So this is of the third thing, that is of vaccine safety. Then chemical safety testing. Apart from that, the toxicity also measured in case of the cell lines. So these are the various uses of your transgenic animals. Here this slide shows about how it has been found of. Before that I said that the milk is containing of a protein, antitrypsin. So the gene which is responsible for the production of antitrypsin was isolated. It was constructed into a vector. Later on that vector may be injected into a cattle. Livestock, it has been added over. It forms of the progeny. This progeny is having the abilities to produce for the particular gene, that is of milk genes. Here it is of fluorescence fishes. Nowadays it is act as a ornamental fishes. The next topic, that is of animal cloning. The meaning of clone is as a xerox copy of a particular animals, we call it as a clone. That is, exact copy of an animal can be done with the help of an rDNA technology. Process of producing genetically identical individual of an organism, either naturally or artificially. So this method we call it as animal cloning. Natural methods means and normal fertilizations will be carried over. Artificial means artificial insemination will be carried over for the productions of animal cloning. The biotechnology refers cloning as a process of creating copies of organisms or copies of cells or DNA fragments. Otherwise, this molecular cloning we can call it as animal cloning. Here I given an example, that is of Dolly. Dolly is nothing but a clone of a sheep. Two sheep has been isolated. This is of mammary cell donor. Otherwise, from the first sheep, the udder cells has been taken over. Udder cells means it's present in the mammary cells from which the milk has been secreted off. From the second sheep, the egg has been collected. That's why it has been called as egg cell donor, and it has been called as mammary cell donor. So from the first donor, the mammary cells has been collected, udder cell is collected. From the second sheep, the egg cell has been collected over. The second step is, from the egg cell, the nucleus has been removed off. Here the fusion of two cytoplasm will be carried over, so that a cybrid has been formed off. The meaning of cybrid is fusion of two cytoplasm, which is having of only one nucleus. So the nucleus has been taken from your mammary cells, the egg cell nucleus has been removed off. That's why it has been called as cybrid. So we form a cybrid having two cytoplasm with of one nucleus. It was grown in a culture. We call it as a cell line. So the single cell was grown under the in vitro condition, that is of laboratory conditions, to form as an early embryo. Later on, this early embryo, the meaning of early embryo is, after the fusion, what happened? It will be divided as two cell. Then it will be converted as four cell, as well as it forms of eight cells. So up to an eight cell stage or 16 cell stage, we call it as an early embryo. It will be injected into a third sheep, we call it as surrogate mother. The meaning of surrogate mother is, it will provide the suitable environment for the development of an embryo. Later on, the embryo will be developed in the surrogate mother uterus. At last, there will be a parturition of a lamb. We call it as Dolly. It is a genetically identical sheep that produced from two donors. One is of mammary cells, another one is of your egg cells. This animal cloning is having of do's and don'ts, nothing but advantages as well as of your disadvantages. The first one is of do's, we call it as an advantages. First advantage is of benefits for clinical trial and medical research. So laboratory trial, if you have produced any vaccines, it can be tried on the particular animal, as well as for the medical research it will be used for. Second one is of save endangered species. So in science we are having of two words, one is of endanger, another one is of endemic. The meaning of endanger is the species at the level of death, we call it as an endanger. Limited amount of species has been present, we call it as endangered species. With the help of animal cloning, we can produce a multiple number of the particular species. That's why it has been mentioned as saving of endangered species. Then compromise human health. For the human welfare, it produces humorous amount of proteins that present in case of milk or meat, whatever it may be of. The third point deals about the human welfare. Don'ts. As like of advantages, the animal cloning is also having of disadvantages. First one, it alters the evolution. The meaning of evolution is the changes that occurs in the human body due to that changes that occurs in the environment. We call it as an evolution. Evolutionary changes, phylogenetic changes that will be occurred over. Here in case of RDNA technology, we are going to change the natural one into an abnormal. Artificially we are creating some changes, we are executing some changes in a normal activity of a cell, so that abnormal effects may be caused to the particular organism, so that the organisms, that is of animal, suffers with of diseases and it may lead to death also. So it is of tedious, that is of very dangerous, and it is of very expensive for the particular research. Then age faster than of normal. The lifespan of the particular animal will be of less when compared to the normal one. At last, it may lead to genetic disorders too. The meaning of disorder is it can't be cured. Why? Because here the nature habit has been altered with the help of a technique to a new one, so that the gene has been altered, or diverse conditions will be carried out inside the body of a animal, so it may lead to genetic disorder. Due to that genetic disorders, some changes occurs in the body, it may lead to death. High mortality rate, mortality is death rate will be occurred over. So this animal cloning is also having of advantages as well as of disadvantages too. The next topic is of ethical issue. So whenever we are using of a research one or research field, there will be of an ethics. The meaning of ethics is the discussions will be carried out based on, our conversations will be carried over based on their do and don't of a particular field. Likewise, in case of biotechnology also, we are having of several advantages. That is, it has been given to the society cheap drugs, better fruits and vegetables, pest resistant crops, indigenous cure to diseases, and lot of controversy also has been provided by the biotechnologies. That controversies we call it as ethical issues. The first one, a powerful application and potential promise to biotechnology raises ethical concern. The meaning for this one is, along with the advantages, it also produces some kinds of controversies too. The major controversy is we are going to ill-treat that animals in the form of testing, laboratory trial. In this slide I have shown on diagram, that is mice which is having of a human ear. So with the help of this cloning or RDNA technology, the gene has been inserted, a foreign gene has been inserted into the mice. So due to that, what happened, an ear like structure has been erased over. So here the normal nature has been converted into an abnormal nature. So with the help of a new advancements, we are ill treating of the animals. It should also be considered as a life. So in case of ethical issues, it was considered you should look after the thing. So that what happens nowadays, genetically modified organisms, for making of it, biosafety guidelines has to be formulated. The meaning of biosafety guidelines is, before making of a research, the entire thing has to be get approved by a committee. Ethical committee is there. With the help of that ethical committee, we have to get a approval for using of an animal cells. The biosafety guidelines have been formulated by many countries for DNA recombinant manipulation. So with the help of that, genetically modified organisms can play a positive role in sustainable agriculture, forestry, aquaculture, bioremediation, as well as of environmental management.